Hi, today we're going to talk about the risks, benefits, and some side effects of immunomodulator drugs, which are, of course, biologics or JAK inhibitors. So direct-to-consumer advertising, the commercials you see on TV, do mention some pretty scary side effects. The biggest question that I'm asked by patients is the risk of cancers like lymphoma. I explain it like this. If you had a stadium that had 10,000 seats in it and nobody in that stadium had RA, then possibly two people in that stadium may end up with lymphoma. Now, if everybody in that stadium did have RA, possibly four people would have lymphoma. And if everybody in that stadium had RA and was taking a biologic drug, it still would be four people possibly getting lymphoma. So the problem is you are more susceptible because you have the disease rather than because you have a specific drug that you're taking. Now, the law says that the pharmaceutical companies must report any type of side effect that happens. So they are reporting lymphomas, and that's why you hear about that. You need to consider what will happen if you don't choose to take medications. You may have worsening of your disease. You can end up with deformities. You may end up disabled. And so it's really important to weigh that against any potential risk. So let's talk about a few side effects of biologics. One of the first things is you may be susceptible to infection. So what we do with the standard of care is to get a tuberculosis test before starting and to test for hepatitis B and C. So we look at those and we make sure that we've got treatment going before we would start the biologic medication. The other thing is we look at how susceptible you may be to infections anyway. And we're able to monitor then what is happening should you get an infection while you're on a biologic. So some of the things that we would do is if a patient got an infection and needed to go on an antibiotic, then we would ask you to hold your biologic while you took that antibiotic, and then you could restart it after you finished. Another infection that we have to be aware of are perhaps zoster infections, or what's called shingles. So what we often like to do is make sure that a patient can get a shingles vaccine before they start a biologic or a JAK inhibitor. The incidence of shingles is higher on JAK inhibitor medication, but again, if we can get vaccines into people, then that usually won't be a problem. Now, another thing that's interesting with JAK inhibitors and IL-6 inhibitors are what are called thrombotic events. And this is like a deep vein thrombosis or a pulmonary embolism. Now, like with lymphoma, patients with RA or other inflammatory arthritides are at an increased risk for thrombotic events. What we want to do is, if you have a history of a thrombotic event, we probably would not start a JAK inhibitor or an IL-6 inhibitor. Another issue are GI perforations, which would mean a perforation or a hole in the bowel. And these have been seen, again, with JAK inhibitors and IL-6 inhibitors. And so if a patient has a history of diverticulitis, where they've had issues or other types of colon type of issues, then we probably, again, would not start those medications in those particular patients. Now, what we do is we monitor blood work and we monitor your symptoms. Every time you come to see us, your blood work may be done every 3 months to 6 months, and we follow those blood counts, look at liver function tests, and we even look at your cholesterol levels. Now, another thing to be aware of as far as cancer goes is that non-melanoma skin cancers are more common in patients taking biologics. The non-melanoma skin cancers are basal cell cancers or squamous cell cancers, and those are often easily treated within the dermatologist's office. But we do recommend that you have a dermatologist and that you see a dermatologist at least once a year for an annual skin check. And then, of course, we would recommend that people are religious in using their sunscreens. Solid tumors like breast cancer, colon cancer, lung cancer do not appear to be increased compared to the general population with patients taking biologics. If you are on an injectable biologic, a pen or a syringe, you may have an injection site reaction. If this reaction is bigger than about a half dollar size, you should give us a call. Generally, these can be controlled with some ice after you do the injection or even before you do the injection, or some type of an anti-itch cream. They seem to clear up. But again, if this becomes troublesome, please contact your rheumatologist. Now, infusion reactions can happen in those patients who are receiving their medication by IV. So your infusion center nurse should go over any types of symptoms with you, but just be aware if something doesn't feel right, you would notify your nurse and let them know if you have any tickle in your throat or itching, burning, anything unexpected. Now, lastly, I'll talk about elective surgery. So if you are going to have an elective surgery, we really need you to hold your medication before that surgery. It could be 2 weeks or more before the surgery, so please call your rheumatologist, give them a heads up that you're going to have an elective surgery, and then they will discuss with you how soon they want you to hold your medication and then when you can restart.